Graffiti is an aesthetic. I come from that school. Dan's, you know, I guess come from illustration. And what we're drawing now doesn't come from the old graffiti motivations of it should be the name and then decorating the name and popping a character on the end. There's no convention, or we're doing away with conventions. It's kind of like an alchemy now.
Quite organic, really, isn't it?
Very, yeah, spontaneous, site-specific, I guess. So it's not, we both have things that we've drawn in advance, but it's not until we're both stood in front of the wall.
That's the fun, really, trying to fit different elements together. There's a lot of standing around scratching our heads, and then we try and paint quite quickly after that.
Paris and Mudwig reinvigorate surrealism with their playful, enigmatic masterpieces. Paris began painting in Hull in the late 80s. By the mid-90s, his crew relocated to Bristol, where they then teamed up with Mudwig, a painter and illustrator who had been altering billboards with his bizarre interventions. The blend of Paris's inventiveness and diverse range of styles and Mudwig's deceptively simple yet unearthly compositions puts them in a zone well outside of traditional graffiti. Together they create bewildering worlds, anomalies as secret and mysterious as the ocean.
I don't think there's an easy way to describe what we do, but we don't easily fit in any kind of category. This is just some unknown territory that we're exploring, and we've always sort of set about to go somewhere we don't quite know.
Like, I always see it as just a load of objects, and you're trying to make a sculpture out of these objects, but you just got like a boot and a sort of broken thing, and it's just about trying to get something to work. For me, not coming from a graffiti background, this is a really good exercise in working with people, because as an artist, there's not many disciplines where you collaborate, so overlapping with each other.
We've always got themes that we'll revisit going on maybe 10 years back. We've just carried on building on that over that time, improving it, like fine-tuning whatever it is.
We meet each other halfway as well. Graham often has to incorporate a certain style in order to give me something to work from. I mean, that's how this piece started. We've brought together all these elements. We need to get this to work. So it's like first thing down, big, we call them the power graphic thing. It's like a monolithical shape that we can, that's the starting point, and then everything grows out of it.
The interactions of the different forms and where they connect, it's almost 60% doing that, and then the actual paintings are almost an afterthought.
There's a design element as well. We try and design something within a space. From a design point of view, we're aware of the value of negative space, which often doesn't occur much in the world of street art. We found it when we painted it out in public spots. We leave a nice white gap because it's got a nice form and it makes everything else have a nice weight. And 3 hours later, some kids come along and just painted in it because he's like, brilliant, there's a space for me. It's like, no, but
that needed to be empty.
Yeah, personally, my work, from some people, like, what is it? And it's like, well, I can tell you what it is, but it doesn't look like that anymore. It's an abstracting of stuff to the point where I take it right back and I've boiled it down so much. It's like a kind of, it's the essence of, and it's supposed to stimulate that part of your brain where you recognize it and it gives you a feeling, but then you're also a bit confused by it because you're like, well, it doesn't look like it anymore, and why is there a stick coming out of it? And that familiarity.
Like a knowing. But
yeah, a knowing with also a confused. I like that. I think it's quite good to flummox people. I don't like stuff to be too straightforward. For us, it's kind of quite refreshing to try and create something different in the world with that general, just kind of cluttered aesthetic.
We strip it right back.
Less is more.